My sister is in an abusive relationship. How can I support her when she won't leave? Imagine it. When you go to sleep tonight, or in a meditation where you can get into a deep trance state where you are not asleep, but you're not fully awake, you are altered. Use that container of space to reimagine a situation with your sister where you are in the same room with her, having a conversation with her, and she's telling you, I finally left. I feel so much better now. I'm healthy. I'm free. I'm no longer being abused. And you're sitting across the table rejoicing and telling her, I'm so proud of you. Now we can do all the things that we wanted to do. Play this out for a long period of time in the imagination while in the altered state of being, until it takes on the tones of reality, until it feels like you're really there having this conversation and your sister's actually saying to you, I left. I'm so happy. I'm free now. And you can feel it. And when you feel it, that's the secret. Hook into it. Stay there as long as possible. If you're meditating, stay in the space of that, envisioning that for as long as possible. If you are doing this right before sleep, drop off to sleep in the tones of that reality. Now, does this mean she'll do it? Not necessarily, but here's what happens. When you create that reality, keeping in mind that anything you do in the imagination is happening, your imagination is real. What happens when it concerns someone else is it sends a transmission of possibility and opportunity, an energetic invitation to them that they can either accept or reject. When someone is in an abusive relationship, they often feel like there's no way out. I'm stuck in a cycle. They don't see the opportunities or don't think they exist, opportunities for them to leave. By you having this imaginative, real conversation with her in your mind's eye where you're feeling it, you're transmitting to her a lifeline. And she can take it or she will not, but you can continue to do it until she does. Now, what happens on her end in terms of 3D is more opportunities begin to present themselves in her reality. Somebody has a conversation with her and says, you know, you don't have to do that. I have a place. You can stay with me. Maybe she comes into contact with resources in her community and it occurs to her. Or maybe she just has an epiphany and she says, I don't need to do this anymore. I'm sick of this. That's what your imagination, your real imagination will allow for her to have in her reality. Facts. It's powerful. Your imagination is real. Directly as it concerns your life, you can create your life from the space of that reality as long as you have an accompanying feeling that supports it. The feeling sends a transmission and tells the universe what to create. For other people, though, you can also change their reality by creating portals of opening and possibility and opportunity by continuing to envision it. Did you catch that? Because that's magic. That's fire. And I do that with people who I want to help who seem like they're closed off. I do that and I keep doing that until they wake up. Most of them do. Not all of them do, but most of them do. To the degree that she chooses not to, that's her path. That's her path. And she's here to walk her path. Whether we like it or not, some people come into this world and they walk really hard paths. And they walk their life. They live their life in ways that seem preposterous to us, in ways that we would never indulge. But they've come here to learn a lesson through a specific kind of life. And it's not for us to judge. It's just for us to hold space and to love and to create possibilities and opportunities for them. My father, for example, lived most of his life as a despicable person. And I thought for the longest time, well, that guy wasted his life. Look how handsome he was. Look how smart he was. Look what privilege he had. Look what money he had. All of it wasted. But I've come to learn that my father came here to experience that. There's lessons there. Now, I believe that at some point he was supposed to self-correct, use those lessons, but he didn't. But none of it was wasted. So careful not to judge. Because when we're trying to help somebody get out of an abusive situation and they just won't go, it's hard not to get exhausted and sometimes even a little angry. Try not to do that because it obstructs your ability to get into your workspace and help her out. Don't judge her, love her, and just send her those lifelines. Get it? Love you.